January 5, Sunday, Solemnity of the Epiphany of the Lord. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising, and have come to do him homage." When the King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests, the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judah, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the stars that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. When they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Herod was greatly troubled. Instead of rejoicing, Herod the Great is greatly troubled when he learns that the King of the Jews is born in Bethlehem. The good news is bad news to him. He is shaken by the child, whom he considers a pretender to his throne. Herod has been in power for 34 years, from 37 BC to 4 BC. From this reckoning, Jesus' birth is dated in 6 BC. He has all the support of the emperors of the Roman Empire. He even outlives many of them. That little boy in Bethlehem is no much for him, but Herod is so afraid of him. Historians tell us that Herod was sick of paranoia. When he saw them as threats to his throne, he murdered Mariam, his wife, and her two sons. He built the Masada, Herodian, and other structures, now tourist spots in Israel, where he would hide just in case. To gain affection and acceptance from the Jews, because he was an Idumean, not a Jew, therefore of pagan blood, he renovated their temple in Jerusalem. But that did not work. Herod will die 2 years after Jesus' birth, but Jesus will not take over his throne. Jesus has a different purpose. He is not here to govern with impunity, to eliminate suspected power grubbers, to establish an oppressive dynasty like Herod's, but to shepherd God's people, Israel. The Magi correctly interpret the leadership of Jesus. When they find him with the help of a guiding star, they rejoice and prostrate themselves before him and do him homage and offer him precious gifts to fulfill the prophecies of Trito Isaiah. They do not see him as a would-be power wielder. They see divinity in him. Jesus manifests himself to them and to Mary and Joseph and some lowly Judeans. Jesus reveals himself to all those who approach him without criminal intentions and are willing to be governed and shepherded by him.